This is wild cherry, Prunus avium. A native tree that is quite fast growing and will only live for 50 or 60 years. The leaves are oval, serrated, and come to a point at the end. And at the base of the leaf, there are two red glands on the stem. The tree flowers in April. It has white flowers that have 5 petals and they hang in clusters of up to 6. And then in summer, the cherries will ripen and they'll become a deep red purple when ripe. They're usually smaller than the cultivated cherries that you'll find in shops, but they're just as edible. You could confuse these with bird cherries, but the difference is, with bird cherries, the stems grow on their own out of the main branch, whereas with wild cherries, they grow in clusters and all meet at the same point on the branch, like here. Now, bird cherries are edible, but they're very sour and they are mildly toxic, so you don't want to eat too many of them. But wild cherries are fine to eat. So the bark of the cherry tree is a greyish brown and it has these distinctive patterns on the bark. I once heard someone say it looks quite like a tiger stripe pattern, and it kind of does. The protrusions on the bark are called lenticels, and they're basically the tree's way of breathing, because it helps the exchange of gas between the tree and the atmosphere. Cherry wood is very strong and it's used in furniture making, and it's also a good firewood because it gives off a nice aroma. Elder is a fairly small native tree. Its bark is fairly light and deeply furrowed. The leaves are separated into 5 or 7 leaflets. They're in opposing pairs and then one terminal leaf. Those leaves are oval and finely toothed. And the petiole is channeled. So you see a little ridge running all the way down. Elder flowers will start appearing from May. They'll form small umbels of white flowers that each have 5 petals. The elder flower has a really nice smell. Some people say it doesn't smell very good. I've even heard some people say it smells of cat's wee. I think what that is when you get the unopened flowers, if you crush them, they do let off quite a horrible smell. And the same with the leaves. If you crush the leaves, they let off a bad smell. You can do quite a lot with elderflower. I really like making elderflower cordial and syrups. In late summer, the elder berries will develop. You don't want to eat too many of these raw because they can cause an upset stomach. They're better cooked for making jams and sauces. When the clusters of berries are a deep purple colour and they're drooping down, then they're ripe. And you don't want to eat the unripe berries because they are mildly toxic. In fact, only the flowers and ripe berries from elder are edible. The rest of the plant is toxic, including the leaves. If you see some dead elder wood lying on the ground, it's got a very light colour. And if you do see dead elder, then keep an eye out for the wood ear fungus, which is an edible fungus that really likes to grow on dead elder. Scots pine is the UK's only native species of pine. It can grow up to nearly 40 metres. Bark is a scaly orange brown. As it gets older, it develops fissures and plates. The leaves of the Scots pine are these thin needles that have a little bit of a curve at the end. They grow in pairs off of a small side shoot. So when you take a pair off, you'll see that they're still joined. So these are edible and they're very nutritious. They've got a lot of vitamins A and C, and you can make a nice tea out of these. If you just get the leaves, cut them up and steep them in hot water. Just don't mistake them with yew, because they're poisonous. Pine trees produce pine nuts, and they come in these hard casings, the pine cone. The pine nuts are edible, but you'd be very lucky to beat the squirrels to them. So Scots pine cones have a little raised circular bump in the middle of each of the scales. And these can be used as tinder because they're very flammable. Scots pine is one of the strongest softwoods and is often used in fencing. Another great use for Scots pine is fatwood, which you'll find in the core of dead trees. Or on living trees, you'll find it where a branch meets the main trunk. There'll be a concentration of fatwood in the centre of the branch. And fatwood is basically wood that's become saturated with resin. And it's very flammable and is one of the best natural fire lighters. You see where the wood is darker there? That is the fatwood. That is where it's absolutely saturated with flammable pine resin. And just from sawing through it, you can really smell the... It smells like turpentine. So what I'll do now is I'll just cut away the rest of the wood, and then you can keep that as a fire lighter. And it's really good stuff because you can get a fire going when it's wet, and you can find this all year round as well. So I've just got a few scrapings of the fatwood and some sawdust from when I was cutting the branch off, and I get my ferro rod, and it should take a spark fairly easily. Another great resource from this tree is pine resin. And you'll find that on cut branches or any damaged parts of the tree, so like where old branches meet the main trunk. And this is edible. It can be basically used as a gum, though it's very sticky and it will stick to your teeth. And another great use for it is if you collect it up and heat it and just add a bit of wood ash to it, then it becomes a very strong natural glue. This is witch elm, a large native tree that can grow to 40 meters. The bark is light brown and can have fissures. It has large leaves that are toothed and pointed at the end, and it can often have a W shape to the end of the leaf. The base of the leaf is not symmetrical, so one side will be higher than the other. And the leaf stems are very slightly hairy. The fruit of the witch elm are these little seed pods that are edible when they're young and green. You'll find them in April, and they taste just like cucumber. There are three main types of lime that you'll find in the UK. This is the most common one. This is small leaf lime, Tilia cordata. It's a native tree that will grow up to around 20 meters normally. And its bark is a reddish brown. As it gets older, it can develop plates, but it's fairly smooth when it's younger. The leaves are heart-shaped with a pointed tip and they're serrated. They're usually asymmetrical, so one side of the heart will be bigger than the other. These are also edible, but these ones are a bit too old. In the early to mid-spring, when they're still translucent, these are a good replacement for lettuce. The flowers appear in early summer. This is an immature flower here. They're a greenish yellow, have 5 petals, and hang in clusters of usually up to 10. They're protected by a wing, and that helps the distribution of the seed by wind. You can make a nice tea out of the flowers. It's supposed to help with anxiety and insomnia. These trees are often planted in parks. If you find them in a forest, it's supposed to be an indicator of ancient woodland. Sycamore is a non-native species of maple, originally from South and East Europe, though they're now naturalised here. The bark is a greyish pink and smooth when they're young, and as they mature they develop grey plates. The fruits of the sycamore are these samaras, or often called helicopters. They're very successful wind pollinators that help the tree spread very fast. The leaves are large and have 5 lobes. And the petioles, the leaf stems, are red. Especially on younger trees. And all species of maple have an alternate leaf arrangement. The wood of sycamore is a hardwood with very fine grain that makes it very good for carving.